So there, I have the snowman all done. All I have to do is put this carriage cam set to the O for stockinette and knit to row 84 on the counter. Oh, I did have to put the yarn back here again. It was tight on the end, so I just pull it out a bit. Now I'm going to do the short rows and reverse short rows for the heel. I have the white yarn back in here. As you know, most Christmas stockings, you put the heel and the toe a different color. You don't have to, it's up to you. If you're doing Fair Isle, then I would suggest just taking one of those colors. You don't want to work Fair Isle. Well, maybe you do. It's up to you, really. I would not do Fair Isle when I'm doing short rows. So what I need to do is take my side levers here, or actually Russell levers, and move them back to the Roman numeral. Well, actually, it's like a dash. But on the other machines, it's on the front, and it would be one or two. Two is for knitting. When you put it to one, any needle here in holding position will not knit. And as I have done many times, I like to do the automatic wrap. I do have the two claw weights, as you could see, and then just to get some weight in the middle here, I put my triangle hanger with a small barrel weight on it. The claw weights will be moved up accordingly as I get on. So now, what I like to do is go down into thirds. You don't really have to, but you have to divide this some way into thirds. Whether you have quite a bit in the middle here and just a few on the end, just to give that shaping of the heel is all. So I take the needle closest to the carriage that's in work position, bring it out to hold. I want to make sure that's nice and tight. I knit across. I take the last stitch that was knitted, put it out to hold, knit across. The last stitch that was knitted, put that needle out to hold. Okay, so I have 25, 26, 27, 28. Well, if I had 30, it would be 10, 10, and 10. 27 would be 9, 9, and 9. So I could go, let's see, 28, 27, be 9, 9, and 10. 28. Yeah. So I'm going to work down to there's just 10 stitches in the middle here that are in work. And then it's going to be the, what did I say, 8 or 9 stitches, whatever, in hold for the heel. Now, some machines you have to move these claw weights up every second row. I think it was the Bond machine I had to do that with more than any other machine. But if you have a problem, you see these stitches starting to pop up off the hooks, you want to get that weight up there, especially the ones that are underneath the needles that are put into a hold here. Normally I would take and knit across, and I would have to manually wrap the needle over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start doing my reverse short rows by bringing two needles opposite the carriage from holding position to forward working position, knit across. Actually, that one needle over here was back and put to hold. So now I'm going to take the last stitch that was knitted, put it out to hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, well, it's still going to work out. But I had the 10 stitches there. So now I take two needles opposite the carriage inside here on the heel, the white yarn from holding position to forward working position, knit across, bring that needle out, and do that all the way down. Now I probably should have done this right on the first row. When you get to the reverse short rows, you don't have to keep moving those the weights up. But as you see, I got 3 claw weights on here now. And that alone right there will help you bring, you don't have to, like I said, you don't have to keep moving these up every so many rows. If you find you're dropping stitches, then yeah, you're going to have to. But I found that when I'm working a heel or reverse short rows like this, that once I get to this point, I don't have to keep moving those up. So I'm going to continue doing this until I get all the stitches right of 0 back into work again. So this is all done. I would have one more needle here if I did not do start the reverse short rows in the beginning there. This would have been fine, but it's no big deal. Even if you were making regular socks with this. But what I want to do is take right one and left one and put it back into the work position. I want to take the purl bump from the row before on the red and just put it on that next needle on right one. So it's going to close that little hole there. I'm going to put my Russell levers back to the two lines, the equal sign. And now I need to knit 36 rows for the foot. Actually, I want to reset my counters so I could see what I'm doing here. I can probably get my cast on comb back on here. I find sometimes it doesn't go on exactly right. So just keep an eye on the comb when you put it back on your work. You may see that some of the prongs there will pop off. Let me see if it does it this time. No, not really. But you would just take and push that back on the stitches is all. Actually, I should have an odd number of rows. It should be 35 or 37, so I could do that short rows over here. That way, when I graft the last row of the white to the beginning of the red here, it's going to be underneath. But it's up to you. I mean, you could do the short rows and reverse short rows in white on this side again if you want. I just like to do it on the opposite side. So I'm going to take the red out. And then I'm going to take, just to be on the safe side, 4 lengths of the red. I don't need this anymore. And then I'm going to take all the needles right of 0. Put them out to hold, put my Russell levers back in, get the white yarn into the carriage. Again, taking the first needle over here on the left, put it out to hold. And I forgot to put my weights on here. I probably could even take the right stitches off. It's up to you. And let's see, let me clip this down. So again, taking the needle that was last knitted from work, pushing it out to hold, knit across. I really don't need the counter at this point, so all I have to do is just go past the needles. Now, if you're using the other type of intarsia carriage, you probably want to knit. Well, this is a Christmas stocking, so gauge doesn't really matter. But I like my stitches to be the same no matter what, and that's why I got this carriage. But if I was using the old plastic carriage, I would use that also for knitting the rows. Although when it came to the short rows, I think you can't really put the needles out to hold position with that intarsia carriage. I no longer have that one, so maybe somebody will correct me on that, and you can. So anyways, if you cannot put the needles out to hold with the other intarsia carriage, then you're going to have to take it off, whether it's waist yarn or a circular needle, whatever your choice. Besides this one here, I'm going to graft on the machine. I'm going to do the easy graft because this is just a Christmas stocking. If this was a stocking for my foot, I would graft it by hand. I prefer that way. Or you could graft it by machine, but I would do a little different than what I'm going to show. So let me finish this and get to that point. So I did take the red stitches off on my circular needle that I keep here. Actually, I could take my claw weights off. Now, if you do not have a garter bar, you're going to have to work waist yarn on this. But I need to turn this around. So I'm going to take one half of my garter bar. I put it on one needle. There's always one there. Keep forgetting to check it. Oh no, there's another one here. I start at one side and I lay it down into the hooks. I find any hooks that did not go into the prongs. I just bend that needle down, get that hook in there. Then I pull the work onto the garter bar. Oh, you want to have those little indents facing up. So I go like that to make sure the latch is open. Then I lay the bar, garter bar horizontal until I feel the hooks catch on the loops there. Then I take it down and pull it off. I push the work back. Then I'm going to take and put the red stitches onto these same hooks. Now, whether you do it one at a time or two at a time, by taking the stitch off of the needle, circular needle, and then put them on the hooks of the knitting machine, anyways, let me finish this, and then I'll show you how to close up this seam. I did cut a good length of the white yarn when I was done. Now I have this set up. I have the carriage over there because that's where the yarn was. If I had the red stitches on the back and the white on the front, then it would have been on the right here. But wherever your yarn ends, you want to get the carriage over there. Now, the real easy way of grafting is you knit one row. And I want to put the carriage to intarsia, seeing that that's the way I got it here. I could have just done a regular stitch. Now I'm going to put it back to the O, and I'm going to see about if I could get at tension dial 10. I may not because I was on 6. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hand knit this last row. Of course, you could do the back stitch bind off if you want, but I like doing the latch toll bind off. So I just hand knit the needles to make the stitches larger than normal. If I was down on, say, tension dial 2 or 3, I probably could have gone to 10. Bring those needles back out to hold, and I have my LK150 latch toll here. I just opposite the yarn tail edge. I go into that loop, take it off, go into the next loop, take it off that needle, pull the second loop through the first loop. And just do that all the way down. And actually, I did not need the 4 lengths of red. I have the red yarn here. That's going to be used to sew up the seam, which is going to be on the back of the stocking. Now, first of all, I need to take all these yarn tails here and weave them in so it will not unravel. Do the duplicate stitch on the snowman and the broomstick here. When that's done, then I'll take and sew up. And there. And when I get to the end here, I would take the white to sew it up and then make a little chain for hanging it up. Or you could put a chain on the back here where it normally would be. Now that really is kind of a small snowman. Probably could have made him a little bit bigger, but oh well. And there, I have it all done. If by chance you ended up with a loose stitch, then you probably want to sew a lining. Just basically draw this pattern minus a little bit so that it fits right inside. Sew up the seam and then sew it in place at the bottom of the cuff.